growing up would be just incredible, little boy that runs around the church, and his baby sister's getting baptized tonight. Has that beautiful, beautiful baptismal gown, and I understand that you crocheted this for me, and it's a beautiful print. Very, very nice. And it's just a real honor to have your family with us, and both sets of your parents.
Yeah.
His parents from India, and so it's our deep honor to have you with us this evening. Brothers and sisters in faith, we come together this evening to celebrate the sacrament of holy baptism. It's this point in our lives that we initiate one another into the body of Christ, incorporate ourselves into God's mighty acts of salvation, and we're given new birth through water and the Spirit. This evening, we present to you the church, Gianna, Sylvia, Angeli, Mohan, for holy baptism. Pastor Sharon would like to ask you the questions of faith this evening.
On behalf of the whole church, I ask you, do you renounce the spiritual forces of wickedness, reject the evil powers of this world, and repent of your sin? If you do, please say, I do.
I do.
Do you accept the freedom and power God gives you to resist evil, injustice, and oppression in whatever forms they present themselves? If you do, please say, I do.
I do.
Do you confess Jesus Christ as your Savior and Lord, put your whole trust in His grace, and promise to serve Him as your Lord in union with the church which Christ has opened to people of all ages, nations, and races? If you do, please say, I do.
I do.
Will you nurture this beautiful young daughter as you have your handsome son, that by your, in Christ's holy church, that by your teaching and example, they may be guided to accept God's grace for themselves, to profess their faith openly, and to lead a Christian life? If you will, please say, I will.
Do you, as the body of Christ, reaffirm both your rejection of sin and your commitment to Christ?
We do.
We can nurture one another in the Christian faith and life, and unto this family now before you in your care.
With God's help, we will proclaim the good news and live according to the example of Christ. We will surround these persons with a community of love and forgiveness, that they may grow in their service to others. We will pray for them, that they may be true disciples who walk in the way that leads to life.
As we prepare our heart for baptism tonight, it's always my custom to have siblings here help us, and your baby sister's getting baptized tonight. Would you like to pour the water into the baptismal font? You know where that water came from? The water came from the Western. But now we're going to add some water that comes from a place far, far away. And this water, you know where this came from? This came from Central America in a place called Nicaragua, where our church built a well, dug a well, for people that had no running water. So one day we went down and visited, and we brought bottles of water home from an organization called Living Waters. So why don't you pour some waters from other places in the world? Yeah. Maybe your grandmas can bring some water from India. Things. These waters indeed come from around the world, and we ask God indeed to bless this water to make it holy this evening for holy baptism. Jesus Christ. Amen. and then friends get to sit in front of the church on baptism. But you know what? Even greater than that is you get those front row seats of life. It might be through Skyping around the world, literally in this case, or it might be those visits here and in India to watch this little baby girl grow up. It takes all of you to model what the Christian life looks like, means like, means, and how that's expressed. And in her life, in the midst of varying cultures, will you do your part to surround her with the Christian faith, to teach her what it looks like to be a woman of faith? If so, you say, we will.
We will.
Do you, the church, allow this beautiful baby girl to remind you of what we're about as a church? That we take a sacred commitment to surround children with the ways of Christ. I think it's very appropriate this weekend in the midst of five baptisms that it happens at the beginning of Vacation Bible School week. The week where the church gets turned upside down. It gets messed up. And things get broken. And we're all happy about it. Because we're not here to create some type of a religious museum. But we're here to create God's playhouse for boys and girls to discover the Christian faith. Will you allow her baptism this evening to allow us to reaffirm our commitment to share the stories of Jesus with boys and girls? If so, we say, we will.
We will.
And I would be remiss to say that it's just a beautiful journey to walk alongside Chris and Preeti to see you guys as a family. And you know, a lot of prayers. A lot of prayers. And, from a medical standpoint, this isn't happening. But from God's standpoint, God has a plan. God has blessed you guys. So I just pray that as your children grow, that you just that you discover that the God purpose. You discover God's purpose for your son and your daughter, and as you guys grow this family,
just I keep moving on your smile.
Pastor Shane, you want to take the microphone out to Pastor Tooney here. Tooney has done, you guys see Tooney and Shakuntala around the church every time the church doors open. You know, they're great church people. And they've done great, great work in the mission field, especially and we've asked to just to offer a word of blessing this evening on our baptism, which I'm
Holy God, we give you thanks again for this life.
For she had, we ask that you will look upon her as a new soul in a new community, that she has the future in front of her, and that she walks that path where your guidance be with her, not only in her home, but wherever she may go. We ask that she may be a part of this community fully and be blessed, and we also give you thanks for her in Jesus' name.